Hi, this is Abhijit and you're watching AB Study Circle. Do like, comment, share and don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss any video from AB Study Circle. In this video, we will discuss a question related to the concept of entropy, and it has also been asked in the CSVTU University Exam in 2010. So, let's dive in. The question is like this: 2 kg of water at 0 degree Celsius is brought in contact with a heat reservoir at 100 degree Celsius. When the water has reached 100 degree Celsius, find the entropy change of water, the heat reservoir, and of the universe. The universe is the algebraic sum of your heat, the entropy change for heat reservoir and water. Okay. So let's draw a block diagram to understand the things. See, this is your heat reservoir. Okay. So it has a temperature of how much? This has a 100 degree Celsius. Now there is a body which has 2 kg of water. Okay, say this is your body. Which has your mass as 2 kg and the initial temperature T1 of this body is 0 degree Celsius, and it's brought in contact with this hot reservoir. When it is brought in contact with this hot reservoir will lose some heat which is gained by this body which has 2 kg of water at 0 degree Celsius. Right? Say this is your Q. The question says that find out the entropy change of water, heat reservoir and the universe when the water reaches 100 degree Celsius. That means your temperature of this body will change to, that is T2 will be 100 degree Celsius. There is a finite, this body, the heat is transferred through a finite temperature difference. Let's find out the entropy change of this body due to this finite temperature difference. The entropy change for water, say dSW, that will be m into CpW into ln T2 by T1. Okay. Right. So we have M how much? 2. CPW we know that 4.187 into ln T2 is 100 degree Celsius. I will be converting into your Kelvin. It will be 373 T1, 0 degree Celsius. When it is converted into Kelvin, it will be 273. Okay, let's put this here. It is 273 Kelvin and it will be 373 Kelvin. Okay. Now, when you calculate this, you will get the value as 2.6135 kilojoule per Kelvin. So, this is your entropy change of a water. This one. Okay. This is your first answer. Now, let's find out the entropy change of heat reservoir. Okay, DS reservoir, it will be minus Q by T. T is the temperature of this reservoir and Q is the heat which is transferred to this body of 2 kg of water. So this Q will be nothing but your M, that is your for water, into CPW, because this heat is transferred to this, right? So the heat which is gained by this will be this heat, right? Okay, will be T2 minus T1, right? Okay, by your temperature T. So let's find out, this is the heat which is lost by this, which is gained by this body, to increase its temperature from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. Okay, so it will be minus 2 into 4.187 into T2 is how much? 373 minus 273. Okay, divided by the T is 100 degree Celsius. It is 100 degree Celsius. So I will be converting into how much? It will be 373 Kelvin. Okay, so it will be 373 Kelvin. So the value will be minus 2.245 kilojoule per Kelvin. Okay, this is your heat transfer, this is your entropy change for the heat reservoir. Now for the universe, DS universe will be DSW plus entropy change of universe. Okay, see, it will be DSW plus DS of heat reservoir, and let's find out 2.6135 plus minus 2.245. okay, and this will comes as 0.3685 kilojoule per Kelvin, and this is your next answer. See, one thing you can see from this whole problem, that this water is receiving some amount of heat from this heat reservoir. Okay, so when heat is added to this system, we see our entropy change is positive, and this heat is a reservoir is losing some heat which is gained by this body. When it is losing some heat which is gained by this body, for this heat reservoir the entropy change is negative. And we have seen that entropy change of the universe is always positive. See, we have got this as positive.